बुद्ध, द साक्यमुनि बुद्ध, द सिद्धार्थ बुद्ध, द बुद्ध ऑफ कपिलवस्तु, द बुद्ध हुज टीचिंग्स आर फॉलोड इन 30 कंट्रीज और मोर. हाउ डज दिस बुद्ध स्टार्ट? वेयर डज ही स्टार्ट? वी ऑल नो द स्टोरी. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ हिज लाइफ was that he was a prince who was protected by his father, because the father thought, according to astrology, his son would either become a king, a very, very wonderful, famous king, or he would become an ascetic, a sannyasi, a monk. The father wanted his son Siddhartha to be a great monarch, and he stops Buddha, he stops Siddhartha, the potential Buddha, from going anywhere. He locks him inside the palace. He gives him everything that at that time that a man could enjoy. Siddhartha enjoys wine, women, wealth, everything. Now there are a lot of people in the world who think that, you know, if you enjoy the worldly things, if you enjoy wine, if you enjoy wealth, if you enjoy women, if you enjoy the bodily requirement, you'll be happy. So did Siddhartha's father. So did Siddhartha. Till one day, this prince is driven out in the chariot and he sees an old man, a man who's walking with a stick, shivering, gray hair, gray beard, wrinkled face, can't see. Siddhartha wonders, who is this man? Because his father has not allowed Siddhartha to experience old age. Siddhartha asks his charioteer, who is this man? And the charioteer tells him, it's an old man. And this old age is something that nobody can run away from. Even you, sir, will become old. This makes young Siddhartha think about life, think about the body, think about aging. In another instance, he sees a diseased man, a man who is suffering from probably arthritis, who can't walk, who's trembling all over. He's not old, but he cannot be classified as healthy. Now, Siddhartha is not aware of this. And he asks the charioteer again, who is this man? And the charioteer says, oh, this man is suffering from a physical disease. You know, all of us get physical diseases. Even I suffer, so will you one day. Again, the young prince starts thinking. Is suffering a part of life? True, all of us suffer at one point or the other, either bodily or in our minds. In another instance, while being driven in a chariot, Siddhartha sees a dead body, a body whose procession is being taken. And there are people crying, wailing, full of suffering. And Siddhartha asks, the charioteer replies, oh, this is but a dead body. That person doesn't live anymore. And this is the truth. All of us will die. I, sir, will die, and you too, one day. Again, the prince starts thinking. These are the inevitable realities. These are the inevitable truths. All of us will get diseased. All of us will get old. All of us will die. That's when Siddhartha the prince says, I have to understand the truth about life. And one day he leaves home. He leaves his wife and an infant child and goes in the quest of truth. Isn't this true to all of us? Are we not all stuck in a world which gives us so much suffering? Are we not stuck in a world where the body gets sick, the mind gets sick? Are we not stuck in a world where we'll get old and one day we'll die? Yet, none of us ever bother to seek the truth. Only if we will, we can all become Buddhas. We are all potential Buddhas.